Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with another tutorial video for you guys. And in today's Shopify tutorial video, we will be learning how to add custom fields in contact form of Shopify. So after following this tutorial, you will be able to add input field like this. And you'll be able to add a drop-down menu like this, a checkbox field, and the radio button fields. Shopify doesn't have any option to add custom fields through UI, so you will have to do it via code. And all of the codes which you need to add in the liquid file, I'll share in the YouTube video description. So if you want to learn, stick to the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Comment in the video below if you have any questions and keep watching. So let's get into it. So guys, that's how default contact form of Shopify page looks like, where you have name, email, phone number, and comment field. Now, if you need to ask additional information from your user, you can add input field, drop-down field, and checkbox field, which I'm gonna show you how. So in order to do that, let's go back to the backend by navigating to /admin. And once you do that, after logging in, you will see a screen like this. And from this screen, from the left-hand sidebar, you need to click on online store. And from online store, you will see your active current theme. In this case, we are editing the contact form fields in Dawn theme. You might have any other theme, but the code should probably be the same. Okay. Now click on actions and edit code, and before doing so, make sure to duplicate the theme. In case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. After duplicating your theme, you'll have it as a copy, like I have it, copy of Dawn. So you can easily revert it back by clicking on publish and then redo the changes which you did wrongly. Okay, now go to actions and then edit code. And from there, search for contact form. And here's the file, which is contact-form.liquid, where we will be adding additional code for input field. So first we'll add our input field, which will show below phone number field. In order to add it, you'll have to add the code on line number 74. So that's the diff for our phone field. We'll be adding our additional input field in line number 74. So that's the code for input field. Again, don't worry about the codes. I'll add a blog post in YouTube video description where you will find all of the code. So you don't need to mess up with the code. Okay, we have our input field added. Now click on save. And then go back to your page and hit refresh. And here we go. Our custom input field is being showing up now. At the end of this video, after adding all of the fields, I'll do a test submission and I'll show you how the value is being passed through contact form. Okay, instead of custom question, if you want to rename it, what you will do is change it here for name and ID. In order to do that, let me show you how. So ask for the user age. I'm going to say, what is your age? And then replace the placeholder with the same value. And here we can simply say age. Similarly, for ID and for attribute, we can simply say age. Now click on save and then go back to your page and hit refresh. And here we go. our newly input field is now asking for your age. Okay, we were successfully able to add the custom input field which was asking age. Now we will add a drop-down field. Now go back to your contact form code, and just below this field we'll add additional drop-down field. So that's the div. Again, the code you will found in the YouTube video description. So I'm going to paste this code here. Okay, now after pasting the code, hit save. And now let's go back to our page and hit refresh to see how the field looks like. Okay, so our drop-down field in Shopify contact form has been added. But as you can see, it's looking a bit weird if you compare it from other fields. So what we're going to do, we'll add some CSS code. Go back to the code editor and search for base. Then you will find the base.css file. Click on that. Scroll down to the bottom. And add the code provided by me in YouTube video description. So I'm just going to copy the code and paste it here. Click save. Go back to the page and hit refresh. And here we go. Our drop down fields looks like the rest of the fields now. Cool, right? Now we'll be adding our checkbox field in Shopify contact form. And that's the code for our checkbox field in Shopify contact form. Copy the code. Paste it below the drop-down menu code which we added. So that's the code for the drop-down menu which we added in contact form. Now hit enter and paste the code. Hit save. Go back to the page, hit refresh. Cool, our checkbox field is showing up now. Now as you can see, we have a little spacing issue here with this field. So what we're going to do, we'll add the CSS code which is being provided. I'm going to copy the code, go back to my base.css file, scroll down to the bottom and add the CSS code. Hit refresh. Now this code should fix this spacing issue in checkbox field of our contact form. Hit refresh. And here we go. Now we can see it looks similar to what we have in other fields, the hover effect and the padding. Okay, now the final is the radio buttons. Code is already ready. Just copy the code, paste it below the checkbox field code which we added in contact-form.liquid. So that's our checkbox field. Hit enter, paste the code, click save, go back to the page, hit refresh, and now we can see our radio button fields in Shopify contact form. Again, this also have the spacing issue which we'll be fixing through CSS. So I'm going to go back to my code file, copy the CSS code, go back to the code editor, click on base.css file, scroll down to the bottom, paste the CSS code, hit save, and now go back again and hit refresh. Here we go. Okay. So in this tutorial, we added a custom input field, a custom drop-down menu, custom checkbox field, and custom radio button field in our Shopify contact form. Now, at the final stage, we will test if all of these drop-down and the input fields and the checkbox radio button fields is passing on the value to the email. Now, I'm going to do a test submission. What is your age? 29. Turns. I'll select shipping. When is the best time to reach you? You can select morning, how do you want us to contact you? Just give me an email, comment, nothing to comment about. Okay, now hit send. And there we go. Our submission has been made. Now I'm going to go back to, I'm going to check my email if we have received the submission properly with the values which we filled on. Okay, so as you can see, we have our submission showing up here. Click on that. And as you can see, we have all of the fields showing up. So these are the default ones. Name, email, phone number, and these are the custom ones which we added. Age 29, request type, shipping, contact time, morning, contact method, email. Okay, cool, right? So we're done with this tutorial, guys. Make sure to comment on the video below and let me know how can I improve and contribute more to make you guys learn about Shopify, web designing and development. Until next video, have a great day.